Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today we're talking about an exciting new update to Premiere Pro to the captioning workflow. There's a new speech to text feature that'll auto transcribe your video, and then you can place your captions directly in your timeline and stylize them further with the Essential Graphics panel. Now this is huge because before the workflow was pretty clunky. You had to use a captioning panel and you couldn't stylize it with the Essential Graphics panel. So the speech to text auto captioning feature is still in early access, so you can apply to be a part of the program and use the feature for free using the link below. But the new captioning workflow and stylization with Essential Graphics is now available today in the public beta, which you can access from the Adobe Creative Cloud desktop app by going to the beta app section. So without talking about it anymore, let's go ahead and jump in and show you how it works. With the new text panel in Premiere Pro, you can auto-create transcription from any sequence. After you click on Create Transcription, it will bring up a new window. From the Transcription Settings window, there are a few options for audio analysis. First, you can choose for Premiere Pro to auto-detect the dialogue in your sequence, or you can choose for Premiere to only transcribe clips that you tagged as dialogue from the Essential Sound panel. And lastly, you can tell it to transcribe the audio on a particular track. There's also a variety of languages to transcribe from, and the Premiere Pro team told me that they will continue to add more languages over time. And then you can hit transcribe. It will then analyze and render the audio to create your transcription. Once it's complete, you will then be able to play back the transcript, and as you scrub through your timeline, you'll see that the transcript tab will highlight in blue what words are spoken, which is super helpful. But better yet, you can click on Create Captions, and it will create a captioning file that you can add to your timeline. Now this part is huge because now you will see at the top of the timeline a subtitle layer, and all of the captions are split up into their own graphic layer at the exact time code that they are spoken. You can also shorten the captions, move them, or cut to split and create another caption from an existing caption. Then from the Essential Graphics panel, you can stylize them by changing the font and size. And from Align and Transform, you can change the location of the captions in your frame by selecting a different zone for the position caption block. If you want to be able to change the style of all the captions at once, you can create a master style. And when you select your master style, it'll change the font, size, and appearance of all the captions in your timeline. So that's all there is to the new captioning workflow in Premiere Pro. I'm really excited for this feature, and I can't wait for the speech to text panel to be available in the app, not just in early access. So remember, you can apply to be a part of the program, and you can actually use the captioning feature in the Essential Graphics panel, so you can start stylizing your captions now today by using the public beta app. And now I want to give a shout out to today's sponsor, Envato Elements. Now you can get 70% off using my link below to get unlimited assets. Now this includes stock video, After Effects templates. If you need some background music for your video, you can use these assets as many times as you want. You can use them forever. I repeat, you can use them forever. You can download any asset that you want and use it in an unlimited number of projects. So you can try it out for the first month, getting 70% off using my link below. And I can also leave some recommendations to some templates that I've used from the library if you go ahead and click down and ask to receive some recommendations in your inbox. So that is all for Elements. Thank you for sponsoring. And now this brings me to this week's comment of the week. Thea Latoro wrote, "Do you have the camera plugged into a power source? I'm confused about the power source battery life." Now Thea commented on my live stream setup video about if you need an external power supply for when you're live streaming with your DSLR camera. And the answer is yes, you need to get a continuous battery source, an AC power adapter that actually just fits into the battery slot instead of a battery, and then you plug it into the wall. So that way you can use the camera continuously and you don't have to worry about the battery running out. So I've linked to different AC power adapters that I recommend for different cameras that you can try out. So I'm using Canon. I also use a Sony RX100, so I've left some recommendations for Lumix, Panasonic, as well as some other cameras down below. So thank you, Thea, for leaving that comment. And don't forget to like this video. It helps grow this channel. And leave a comment below if you guys have any more questions. And yeah, that's it for this video. If you want any other Adobe update videos, such as an update in After Effects, there's a new rotoscoping feature that I'd love to share with you. If you want me to do a tutorial on that, just be sure to give this video a like. And if it reaches 5,000 likes, then I know for sure you guys want me to cover that topic. So yeah, that's it. We'll see you guys next time. Bye.